Everybody right now seems to be up in arms about the fact that the Senate, basically Mitch McConnell, to be honest, is doing nothing to protect our elections ahead of the 2020 election. And we should be upset about it. We should be angry about it. We need to protect and secure our elections. And that applies not just to the voting machines and the voting systems, but also to the fighting of misinformation coming out that we've already seen quite a lot of. Now, when I say misinformation or fake news, whatever you want to call it, about 2020 presidential candidates or our elections in general, everybody, I'm sure, thinks of Russia, right? Russia's the big name. Russia's popular. Hell, even in the Epstein conspiracy theories that popped up immediately after his death, you had people like George Takei, you had Joe Scarborough all saying, oh, this seems very Russian to me because Russia's the big boogeyman everybody's going to talk about. Well, folks, yes, we do know that Russia interfered in 2016. We do know that they spread propaganda, misinformation, and fake news ahead of 2016, and I'm not saying it's not a problem. What I'm saying is it never was and is not now the biggest problem. Because much like a cheesy horror movie, the misinformation is coming from inside the House. And to be more specific, coming from inside the White House. You know, we're so worried about these foreign actors coming in and buying Facebook ads or spreading, you know, fake hashtags on Twitter to get something trending that we're ignoring the fact that Republicans in the United States right now are actually leading the charge in spreading misinformation ahead of the 2020 presidential election, and nobody's doing it more than the Donald Trump campaign. And here's what I'm talking about. We have seen them help spread these deep fake videos. You know, the slurred video of Nancy Pelosi where she sounded drunk, but oh, somebody just slowed it down a little bit. We've seen it with their fake ads. You know, with AJ from Texas, as the Washington Post pointed out, who actually happened to be a model from a different non-American country. They can't even give those jobs to Americans. They're outsourcing their own campaign ads. We have seen it with everything this administration has done. One Trump campaign staffer was busted creating these fake websites for Democratic candidates while only listing the horrible things they've done, the bad things they've said, the stupid things they've said on these websites. That's the same kind of crap we all got super pissed about Russia allegedly doing, except the Republicans are the ones who are doing it now. As I said, the call's coming from inside the House, folks. Republicans are leading the way. And you want to know what's even more sick than that? There's nothing we can do about it. As in, we can't stop them from doing this. The First Amendment of the U.S. Constitution does provide very broad protection for freedom of speech. Satire is, it's protected. So we could say fake news all we want. We can say misinformation all we want. But it is still protected. They have no right, or no legal obligation, I should say, to tell the truth. So this kind of misinformation is going to stick. It's going to continue to be put out. And again, Republicans are leading the charge. So maybe in our fight to prevent other countries from interfering with our 2020 election, maybe we also might want to spend some time focusing on what the Republican Party itself is also doing. Because if we think the only people who want to sway this election by spreading fake news are outside our borders, then we are the ones who have completely missed the point. Because nobody right now is doing more misinformation, spreading more fake news than the Republican Party. Thanks for watching, everybody. And don't forget, if you like what you see here, like, comment, share, and subscribe to our channel. And now you can also become a member of Ring of Fire and get exclusive early access to certain Ring of Fire videos all throughout the week. Just click on the little join button right below the video.